Hey everyone, what's going on? Greg here again from Team Blast. So I onboarded a new Google business profile on Monday. And when I went into their profile, I saw that there was that pending edit message. So when I clicked on edit profile, and I'm going to use TM Blast as the example for this video, but when I went to their profile, it was their service area. It said it's going to take up to 30 days now to review. Usually when you make a change within Google, it says it could take up to 10 minutes. And then if your profile is verified properly and everything like that, it usually gets pushed through. I have seen instances where some changes could take a day or two, but for the most part though, these changes should go immediately through. If you get that 30 days message, there's a problem, which is why I'm recording this video. So on Monday, when I noticed that they had a service areas problem, I went through a small number of steps to gain trust with Google before I made the service area change. So on Monday, they didn't have their business hours. So this is a new profile that they created, but they had a service area problem. So on Monday, I made changes to their hours. I feel like that was a trust signal that was missing with Google. So I made those changes. Google immediately accepted that. On Tuesday, I scrolled all the way down here to their service options. I clicked on that pencil icon and I checked off that they do English and Spanish. And then what I also did was when I exited out of this over here, I went to their edit services. Now, notice what happens here. When I log into my profile, I see this about every week or so, Google will come up and say, hey, here's things that based off feedback or based off your profile or website, these could be services that you provide. So you want to click on edit over here. So what I notice a lot of times is that when Google is suggesting edits and then you're trying to make an edit, you might run into this conflict. So I started really small, the hours and the two languages, made those two changes. Then I went through and I checked off everything that is applicable to that business. Then on Wednesday, so that's today, I went to edit profile for their business. Let me just have this load. And then I went to their service areas over here, clicked on the pencil icon. I added in another city and I did that purposely because I was trying to trigger a slight change. So instead of just waiting for Google to take the 30 days to review the cities, I just added in a new city because you have up to 20 you can list. By adding that, it did a complete refresh. It went from 30 days to a 10 minute review and then immediately got approved. So that was the steps I did. So I wanted to start off really slow and build trust within my profile to now be able to push that change. If you make the changes that I suggested and nothing works, you can contact Google. So you want to click on these three dots over here, click on help and support, and you want to scroll all the way down to contact us. Just be cautious with this. I have seen this plenty of times now with clients I've worked with for the past year or two who have a Google business profile. I have onboarded clients that had multiple profiles that's actually a violation of Google's quality guidelines. I've onboarded clients that have had PO boxes or virtual offices for years that, again, would not fly with the current guidelines within Google. I've onboarded clients that no longer work out of their business location, but they're still showing it. So the reason why I shared those examples is that if you contact Google, because there's something about your profile that Google is having an issue with and they're not pushing those changes, it could be because some third-party entities are not matching exactly, or they're not quite sure if you actually operate out of that location. So the reason why I share this is because if you contact Google and you say, hey, I'm trying to push these service areas, they might ask for a re-verification. So again, if you don't actually work out of this physical location, it's actually going to cause a problem. Your profile could be suspended because they're going to say, hey, you actually don't work out of here. You can't do the video verification. Therefore, we're going to remove your profile. Same thing also, if you have multiple profiles, they'll actually look at that and say, you're in violation of our quality guidelines. Therefore, we're going to shut down those profiles. Or maybe you're working out of your home. And again, that's not properly zoned. There's no outside sign. Maybe you got this approved years ago before they were pushing video verifications. Your profile might get removed. So I'm sharing this because, again, if you are a legitimate business, you work out of a location, or if you're a service area business and you've done the proper verification with like the van in your driveway and it shows you can get access to that to then drive out to service your customers, you're all set. Feel free to contact Google. If there's still a bug, you can get that. They'll actually look at that, probably do another video verification, but then they'll push the change. But if your profile is, what I was mentioning before, just be cautious, because if you do that, your whole profile could be removed, which means you have no more impressions or leads for your business. Anyway, I hope this video was helpful. Again, if you have those pending edits, it's frustrating, but hopefully my tips that I kind of shared might make the difference for your profile. Anyway, thanks for watching and stay tuned for the next one.